Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Please take your seats. The ceremony will begin in 5 minutes.
Please stand. Thank you. Hello, everyone. So I will be reciting a poem I wrote commenting on our shared high school experience and what we have to be thankful for in relation to that experience. I would like to express my gratitude for the teachers who held our hands through all the tests and tears, for the teachers who pushed us past limits we didn't even know we had, for the teachers who taught us how to function on 2 hours of sleep or less, for the coffee and candy and energy drinks that kept us awake and alert for hours upon hours of homework and studying and testing. I'd like to thank whatever or whoever is watching over us for gifting us with the resilience needed to endure an IB education, but also for the fortune to ever have had access to such a rigorous and extensive educational experience. Most importantly, I would like to thank our friends, because without all of you, we never would have survived the looming monster we've all come to know and love, the IB. We've been through hell and back, and I'm so grateful we made it back better, bolder, and brighter. Thank you.
May everyone please rise for the national pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, with liberty and justice for all.
All right, and now for the Texas Pledge. Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to thee, Texas, one state under God, one and indivisible. Thank you.
Good morning, my name is Blake Stoltenberg, and today I have the privilege to introduce Mayor Wheat. When I first moved to the town of Westlake, this is pre-Starbucks I should add, the town of Westlake was very small, a couple cluster of homes and the picturesque Solana office buildings. However, now Westlake has entered a new age, the post-Starbucks epic, if you will. Mayor Wheat has ushered in desirable transformations for Westlake Academy and the community as a whole, while maintaining the nature-focused ambiance we've learned to love. It's hard to think about the town of Westlake and the transformation it's undergone without attributing much of it to Mayor Wheat, but it's even harder to think of what the town of Westlake would be like without her. We see her in many ways. She's an accomplished corporate attorney, a wonderful mother, a smiling face that greets you on the sidewalk, a scholar who imparts her wisdom on the youth, and the woman behind the drastic changes I spoke about earlier. I think I speak for every student, parent, and resident when I say thank you for the work you've done in our community. It's my honor to welcome Mayor Wheat to this event.
Wow. Thank you, Blake. Oh my goodness, as Blake mentioned, I am Laura Wheat, and I am the mayor of the town of Westlake. And as such, I'm the president of the Board of Trustees of Westlake Academy. On behalf of my colleagues on the board and council, It is my distinct privilege to welcome you all today to the 12th commencement exercises of Westlake Academy, this year honoring the Westlake Academy class of 2021. I'm joined on the dais today, or the dugout, as it were, by my colleague on the town council, Raj Trivedi, by our school superintendent and town manager, Amanda DeGan, by our executive principal, Dr. Michelle Bryson, by our principals, Dr. James Owen, Kayleen Rudd, and Rod Harding. Of course, our beloved college counselor, Mr. Carl Tippin. And truly the man of the hour who's going to make sure that none of us trip coming up and going down the stairs, Coach Alan Burt. I know I speak on behalf of all of us that we are just thrilled to be here today and to be able to celebrate with you this momentous occasion. First, to the parents of our graduating seniors, I'd like to start with you, because woohoo, you made it to graduation day. It doesn't matter if this is your first child to graduate, your last, or you're somewhere in between. I know that this last year has been one incredible emotional roller coaster, and that today is one incredibly emotional day. One of the many things that I have identified about the positive things of getting older is that I know I will never again have to be in your shoes. And I don't know if you are anything like me, but when I was in your shoes, the term commencement totally confused me, because I've always thought of commencement as having something to do with beginnings. And I'm telling you, graduation day felt nothing like beginning, rather just one giant ending to a very large part of my life. To be honest, the commencement part of today probably doesn't have a lot to do with you. It has everything to do with these amazing young men and women to my right who are literally bursting with pride and excitement and anticipation and ready to set the world on fire. It is indeed their beginning, their commencement. And if the truth be known, you wouldn't have it any other way. You have worked hard to get here, and it is a privilege to be in these seats. To be clear, those 18 or so years of sleepless nights and endless carpools and missing homework and lost ties and limitless love and undying devotion have paid off. As my now 92-year-old mom would say to each of you, you done good. Congratulations. To our seniors, I of course want to congratulate you on your graduation. But more importantly, I want to congratulate you on the choices that you have made that brought you here today. First, I congratulate you on your choice of Westlake Academy. More importantly, I congratulate you on your choice to stay. Rumor has it that there may have been some neighboring schools from which it might have been easier to graduate. But you didn't choose easy. You chose IB and all that it entailed. You chose a path to become a global citizen, armed with everything it takes to to create a better and more peaceful world through intercultural respect and understanding. That is not easy, but boy, it's powerful. I'm suspecting that you have figured it out, that it's the choices that you make that inform the person that you are. So I encourage you to continue to choose wisely. The books you read, the company you keep, the causes that you support will all inform the person that you become. You know, I know that in the 4 years to come and in the decades after that, you are going to come up with more to-do lists than you can imagine. But I submit that there's a list out there that deserves far more focus. It's your to-be list. Answering the question, what I want to do, that's important. But answering the question, who do I want to be? That's existential. And as you're reflecting on that question and you're thinking about what's going to go on my to-be list, I so hope that you don't stray far from those IB learner profile traits. They really are genius. To be a thinker, to be reflective, to be an inquirer, to be a communicator, to be knowledgeable, to be caring, to be willing to take a risk, to be principled, open-minded, balanced. Those are traits that deserve to be on any to-be list. And they are traits with which each of you is intimately familiar. So I encourage you, craft that list, keep it out in front of you, front and center, refer to it daily, and make the choices necessary to bring it to life. And then watch what happens. Watch as the world around you becomes a better place because of who you have chosen to be. I want you to know that everyone here today is so proud of you. We are so excited for you. We are pulling for you with everything we've got. And we can't wait to see the future that your choices create. Once again, on behalf of Westlake Town Council and the Westlake Academy Board of Directors, congratulations on this, your commencement.
Good morning. It is my distinct pleasure to introduce this year's salutatorium. Sarah grew up in Keller, Texas, where she attended Keller Middle School before enrolling at Westlake Academy in the ninth grade. At Keller Middle, Sarah developed an affinity for flute and music, leading her to join the wind ensemble in grade 7. She continued this interest through high school, becoming the principal flutist of the Lone Star Youth Orchestra and Fort Worth Philharmonic. Beyond flute, Sarah also enjoys other extracurricular activities, from painting and drawing to needle felting and sculpting. She has a passion for the visual arts, winning the 2020 Texas Congressional Art Competition Juror's Choice Award. Additionally, she has joined various school organizations such as Rotary Interact and HOSA, and is a member of the Spanish Art and National Honor Society. Next fall, Sarah will be attending the University of Texas at Austin to study business with a pre-med track. Please welcome our salutatorian.
Good morning, students, family, and faculty. To begin, I would like to thank you all, teachers, friends, and family, for coming here today to celebrate with us. We would not be standing here today without you and the efforts you have invested into this class. You have all had a significant impact on the development of the graduates sitting before you today. Also, I would like to specifically thank my twin, Samuel Jong. Without you, I would have failed chemistry, and without me, you would have failed calculus. I wouldn't be in this position without you, so thank you. Needless to say that the class of 2021 has faced many challenges leading up to this day. In the middle of junior year, the COVID-19 pandemic led us to take classes solely online for the first time. In the fall of senior year, we juggled the task of completing our extended essays, college applications, finishing IAs, keeping up with classes, all whilst living in a pandemic. The second semester was barely better. As we continued to prepare for our IB and mock exams, a snowstorm hit, causing the school to shut down for a week and leaving most of us without basic utilities. Despite these challenges, we finally did it. But today is not just about acknowledging the obstacles you have faced to get to this point. Today is more so about your accomplishments and achievements that have led you here. Today is no small feat, potentially the most significant and long-awaited accomplishment most of us can claim to this day. Graduating high school has been a 13-year-long journey for all of us. Whether you began at Westlake from kindergarten or just joined in DP, everything has led up to today. Never hesitate to recognize how proud each and every person here today is for you for accomplishing this journey. Reflecting on these 13 years and the efforts put in by each and every graduate, it is difficult to ignore the diligence, patience, determination, and dedication embodied in the attitudes of each and every one of you. We finally finished, and what awaits us after is boundless opportunity. And I hope each of you chooses to pursue what will make you feel the most accomplished and satisfied. Looking at us, the class of 2021, it has dawned upon me that after today, we may no longer be gathered together again in one place like this. And while that is a sad thought, I am also filled with anticipation, because without a doubt, I believe that each and every single graduate sitting before me has the potential to succeed. Whether you are off to college, or taking a gap year, or looking for employment, your experiences at Westlake are bound to help you in some way. If the accomplishments of this graduating class, despite the adversities we have faced, are any indicator of what we will accomplish in our futures, the future looks promising. Throughout my years in Westlake, I have not only gained the knowledge of the subjects I have studied, but I have learned many other lessons as well. Because while academic intelligence is one thing you can gain from this education, it is only a small portion of it. Westlake has helped me to build priceless skills, as well as instill the value and the ability to succeed. My education at the school has not only taught me the importance of knowing a concept, but also genuinely understanding it, and having this mindset has made all the difference for success. If you believe you can achieve anything and don't allow others to tell you differently, what you are capable of achieving is genuinely amazing. I would like to conclude my speech with a quote from the mangaka and author Aizawa. Don't just give up. Life is about getting knocked down over and over, but still getting up each time. If you keep getting up, you win. I encourage you, the class of 2021, to follow the opportunities available to you that will make you the happiest without giving up. Thanks again to all the families, friends, teachers, and any others I have missed for your contributions. They are greatly appreciated. Your efforts to educate and help us are something we are deeply thankful for and will be remembered even beyond the school. Congratulations again, class of 2021, and I wish you all the best of luck.
It is now my privilege to introduce the valedictorian of the class, Kimberly Wang. Kimberly grew up in Fort Worth, Texas, where they attended Woodland Spring Elementary. During their time in elementary school, they immersed themselves in every topic they could explore, from the vast expanse of planetary systems to every orifice of the human brain. At Trinity Meadows Intermediate School, flute playing, martial arts, and long-distance running soon became Kimberly's top priority. When they joined the International Leadership of Texas in Keller for middle school, they became the second chair flutist in the wind ensemble, a black belt ranked martial arts mentor, and a track and field state medalist. Kimberly enrolled at Westlake Academy their freshman year, excited to take on what high school had to offer. Throughout high school, Kimberly explored many interests in politics, social activism, art, service, and STEM. Having a penchant for teaching others, Kimberly shared what they learned through founding and leading clubs such as Youth in Government and the Youth Board of the International Esperanza Project. Because of their many interests, Kimberly's career aspirations have oscillated between quantum computing researcher, physics professor, human rights lawyer, and many more. Regardless of their chosen profession, Kimberly hopes to positively impact others by thinking critically, differently, and compassionately. Next year, Kimberly will be attending Harvard University to study computer science. Kimberly hopes to become an engaged member of Harvard's social activism and leave Harvard a better school for its future students. Please welcome Kimberly.
Welcome, friends, family, and faculty on this exciting morning. I'm sure your pride and anticipation is a feeling that many of you will never forget. I'm gonna be honest, writing this speech really sucked. In the last few weeks, I'd stare at my laptop screen, racking my brain for the right words to celebrate this occasion. I just couldn't, and even now, can't quite grasp that we, the class of 2021, actually did it. After late nights spent studying for summatives and early mornings note-taking half asleep, you are all sitting here before me in your final moments before becoming official high school, IV, graduates. Today would have not been possible without your courage, perseverance, and most importantly, willingness to change. I can say with confidence that each of you sitting here before me is a different person than you were freshman year, than you were even yesterday. But I have to say I am personally thankful that 2017 Kim is in the past. In all seriousness though, it was through your immense self-reflection and maturity that you were able to adapt, overcome, and improve despite unprecedented adversity in the last few years. We cannot only thank our individual strengths for such a feat, however. We would have never made it here without the support of all the important people in our lives. The support of friends who uplift us in our lows and embolden us in our highs, a family who have sacrificed everything for us just to get a seat at the table, and of staff who have influenced us through unique and challenging education while offering a place, whether in person or online, to develop core memories, learn fundamental lessons, and form serendipitous friendships among both students and teachers. I'd like to especially thank my parents and grandparents, Popo and Agong, for enabling my childhood and now future of exploration and discovery. I urge you all to thank those around you who have and will continue to encourage us after today. Truthfully, when I first came to Westlake Academy, I was intimidated and quite anxious for what my future here held. Yet it was soon enough that the people at this school melted my worries away. It's thanks to amazing teachers like Mr. Llewellyn and Mrs. Harrell, who are always happy to stay after school to help students, that physics and English became my two favorite subjects. Their love for teaching is always apparent and always leaves me in awe. Pero no se preocupe, señora, I still love Spanish. It's thanks to friendly faces like Fallon and Serene, who asked me to sit with them at lunch on my very first day. You are all some of the most genuine and sincere people I have ever met. It's thanks to Westlake's small, close-knit community that I know I could strike up a conversation with any one of you and leave it smiling. The WA family will always hold dear in my heart. You have taught me more lessons than you can imagine, and I can only hope to have done the same for you. Each of you, whether you found it or have yet to find it, have a niche, a special role in this world that no one else but you can fill. What you do with that role is very much up to you. There are so many variables in this world that we cannot control. Unfortunately, unlike in Mr. Talley's class, ceteris paribus, or assuming all things equal for our non-economic students and geeks, doesn't carry really well in the real world. And that's especially apparent in these last 2 years. Yet while we can't control our infinite possible futures or even Mother Nature's showers, we can control how we interpret, consider, and act. As you all look towards your futures, I hope you continue to change, to evolve. In the words of the 14th Dalai Lama, the goal is not to be better than the other man, but your previous self. Regardless of whether you stick to your current life plan, veer off into the path less traveled, or simply see where life takes you, I urge you all to consistently self-reflect and think differently, critically, and compassionately in everything you do. And if you are all as smart and resourceful as I think you are, yesterday's failures will become tomorrow's successes. I wasn't always this hopeful or enthusiastic about the future. If anything, I was constantly anxious about it. But it was you, the class of 2021, who inspired my change in perspective. You taught me to break out of my shell and grow into the individual I am before you. So now, with sweaty palms and my adrenaline rushing, I will say wholeheartedly, don't ever stop listening, learning, and growing. Your life is yours. What will you make of it?
Good morning. It is an honor to be standing here today reflecting on the class of 2021. To assemble a short speech that can wholly capture the spirit, the fortitude, the grit, the gumption of these outstanding soon-to-be graduates is a formidable task. After all, when reflecting on the memories these wonderful students have created, it's impossible to wrap them all up in an easily digestible theme. It is more like looking into a kaleidoscope, with every change in viewpoint revealing different moments of fun and frivolity, challenges and adversity, and then back to triumph and success. If a clear theme for this reflection isn't immediately at hand, then one of the phrases that has so recently infiltrated our lives comes more easily to mind. I'm sure all of us, at some point in the last 15 months, have written, spoken, or heard the phrase, "These are unprecedented times." Now, of course, as Kimberly has pointed out, these have unquestionably been unprecedented times. Though the curious historian in me begins to ask, to what extent are these times actually unprecedented? And it is here, as a historian, that I found my route into reviewing the journey of the class of 2021. For this reflection, I've set myself just one task: to answer the question, to what extent was the brilliance of the class of 2021 unprecedented? In answering this searching question, I must, of course, construct a thesis statement. For this, I do not have to think for long. Seniors, the educational journey you began 15 months ago had little to no roadmap, no immediate signage to help navigate what lay ahead. This was not a situation faced by your predecessors. This was a unique challenge requiring unique brilliance. So my thesis writes itself. Without a single doubt, the brilliance of the class of 2021 was unprecedented. But like all good historians, I'm now going to have to prove it with irrefutable evidence. So here we go. Now, of course, in true essay style, I need to develop a structure to support my argument. So in keeping with my historical approach, I thought I would draw upon the words and wisdoms of some past US presidents. I'll start with one of my favorites, the peerless Teddy Roosevelt, who once said, "Nothing in the world is worth having or worth doing unless it means effort, pain, and difficulty." Well, arguably, Roosevelt would say that. He fashioned himself as a bull moose. But nevertheless, in this context, class of 2021, your brilliant efforts in facing and then conquering the difficulties that laid in your way were truly unprecedented. You navigated the early days of Google Meets, successfully straddled the two lands of in-person and remote education, and mastered the terrain of hybrid learning. You engaged and learned with each other, no matter whether it was in person in the classroom, remotely in the living room, or in the odd case, what appeared to be inside of your own moving car, with what looked suspiciously like a freshly purchased Chick-fil-A meal, nestling guiltily on the edge of the passenger seat. Now to the next phase of my argument. As this is the class of 2021, I thought I would also draw upon the president who ended his term 100 years ago in 1921, Woodrow Wilson, who once said, "I not only use all the brains that I have, but all that I can borrow." I believe this statement is apposite. Spending time in your classrooms this year and listening to your amplified voices broadcast themselves from the Google Meet, it was clear that you were not only relying on your own brains, but once again, showing your brilliance by collaborating with each other, exchanging evidence, arguments, and ideas. And was this brilliance unprecedented? Of course it was. Don't be silly. Not even the absence of a physical classroom could stop you from joining educational forces, spurring each other on with your infectious goodwill and sense of humor. If I were to use a phrase associated with James Monroe, president in 1821, 200 years ago, and say that you created your own era of good feelings, you could possibly argue I was going a little too far, but I don't think I am. The way you laughed, joked, joshed with each other was endlessly endearing, underscoring a humor in adversity that was unprecedented in its brilliance. Now, as you all know, a good history essay also needs some different perspective to evaluate. Here I turn to a presidential quote, which at first glance may not seem so applicable, but bear with me. President Ronald Reagan once said, "When you can't make them see the light, make them feel the heat." Now, to be sure, there were odd moments of hijinks sprinkled throughout the past year when I thought I might need to invoke my principal voice and, in Reagan's words, make you feel the heat. Moreover, in keeping with the Cold War context of Reagan's quotation, there was the occasional time when a US-style policy of containment towards any senior tomfoolery may have seemed appropriate. But you were all too charming, too funny, too adorable for me to ever stay mad at you, even for a fleeting moment. And to be so funny, adorable, and charming through trials and tribulations of recent times, well, that must surely mean that once again, your brilliance is unprecedented. So now that I have presented my evidence to support my thesis and evaluated a different perspective, I need my conclusion. And in offering one, I thought I would finish with a quotation, not from a US president, but from a British prime minister. Winston Churchill once said, "Success is not final. Failure is not fatal. It is the courage to continue that counts." Class of 2021, your courage is like a thread that runs through every seam of the evidence that I have presented. Your courage in facing up to and overcoming what Shakespeare's Hamlet called the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune. You have left me in complete and utter awe of you. Your spirit, fortitude, grit, gumption throughout these unique times has been an act of sustained, individual, and collective brilliance, and one that is truly unprecedented. Congratulations to you all.
Congratulations, class of 2021. You have achieved something that few others have. You are graduating from an IB World School that offers the full continuum of IB programs. This is indeed a huge accomplishment. The faculty and I are so proud of you. We know that you are prepared head and shoulders above your contemporaries and are ready to face the challenges that life in an ever-changing global landscape sends your way. You will begin this journey, this new chapter, at some of the world's finest institutions of higher learning, from the University of Chicago and SMU, to Harvard and the University of Texas, to Johns Hopkins and the University of Virginia, to Vanderbilt and the University of Richmond, Pepperdine, Columbia, Texas A&M, and so many other colleges and universities in between. There is no doubt that you are fortunate young people. You've heard me say that many times this week. You have been given the gift of an IB World education. More importantly, you have earned it. You know the value of international mindedness and the power of thinking globally and acting locally. These are formidable tools that will serve you well as you chart your journey in life. But you have been given so much more. You have been given the opportunity to develop the attributes of the IB learner profile. In doing so, you have become open-minded thinkers who are knowledgeable of the world and able to effectively communicate the human condition in a reflective, caring, and principled manner. You are risk takers in your disciplined inquiries of your world as you balance the complexities of your lives, the IB learner profile. You are entering the world where these attributes are more important than ever before. We live in a world of rapid change. Rest assured that you are prepared. You are armed with a rare perspective unique to your IB education. As such, charged with the mission to find your common humanity with your global contemporaries to change the world for the better. So before you move your tassel from the right to the left, we would like to share one final nugget of wisdom with you. As I shared at the senior banquet with you, one of my favorite quotes is from the noted sociologist, writer, and futurist Alvin Toffler. Toffler asserts in his book, Rethinking the Future, that the illiterate of the 21st century will not be those who cannot read and write, but those who cannot learn, unlearn, and relearn. In order to truly understand, which was the object of TOK, you need to continually engage in the process of learning, unlearning, and relearning. Those who fail to master this very essential skill will find themselves repeating the same mistakes and expecting different results. Rapid change requires examination, examining what we know and how we know it. It requires acknowledging that knowledge is dynamic, not static. So let's spend the time that we have left together as a class, as a collective group, to unpack the power of unlearning. First and foremost, unlearning and relearning is the foundation of lifelong learning. It is a conscious act of letting go of outdated information and actively relearning by gathering new insights to inform effective decision making. Simply put, it is to do away with the old to give way to the new. A clearer description, according to Barry O'Reilly, business advisor and author of Unlearn, it is not forgetting what we know, but stepping back from it to be able to see things differently. It is about effectively learning from our personal history as well as our collective history. Henry David Thoreau, one of our house namesakes, gives us powerful advice. He states that when any real progress is made, we must unlearn and learn anew. There's real power in unlearning life's lessons. There is no doubt that our experiences shape us into who we are. Our environment, our education, social interactions, skills, dreams, mistakes, triumphs, shape and reshape us over time. In the words of a noted philosopher, in order to attain knowledge, add something new every day. In order to obtain wisdom, remove something every day. The first steps towards understanding is accepting that our current knowledge may be insufficient to fully tap our full potential. Former Prime Minister Winston Churchill once said, "Those who do not learn from the past are destined to repeat it." So learn, unlearn, and then relearn, and plot a new bold course. This is your moment. This is your journey. Remember that there is power in unlearning. It opens you up to the art of new possibilities and allows you to see the world with eyes wide open. As you do so, we urge you to think critically, be open-minded, and think differently. The future is yours. You are ready. We wish you the very best that this world has to offer. Please help me congratulate the graduating class of 2021.
Griffin Ault. Joshua Amos. Sarah Erin Sibia. Vidhat Ashok Kumar. Woo! Riley Bernard. McKenna Barton. Kai Beeman. Claudia Bort Gill. Jaden Boswell. Ashlyn Bolden. Jude Butler. John Dickey. Jacqueline Dietrich. Ose Imafo. Gabriel Falcon. Hannah Farrell. Griffith Fitzgerald.
Congratulations, my friend.
Chandler Flowers. Hayden Flowers. Matthew Good. William Ralty.
Congratulations.
Yeah. Aaron Guy. Ainsley Hamilton. Alec Hankins. Congratulations. Lily Hansen. Connor Hart. Ashley Helms.
Congratulations.
Anthony Reed Hernandez. Ingrid Jackson. Kara Jackson. Nolan Jepson. Alexis Jong. Samuel Zhang.
Congratulations, my friend.
Sarah Zhang. Macy Cato. Zane Kershaw. Chase Koshin.
Congratulations.
Aniston Larson. Philip Long.
Congratulations.
Parker Lovin. Gentry Luckett. Micah Matthews. Jackson McBride.
Congratulations, my friend.
Cameron McClellan. Zenobia Morrison.
Hello. Right, you're going to shake my hand. Come here. Shake my hand. Congratulations.
Fallon Muller. Ariel NJ. Avocet Odom. Blake Olson. Jake Orr. Allison Pack. Serene Ponde. Ekta Patel. Nicholas Petersilge. Gabron Pillai. Kayvon Robinson. Paul Sorlia.
Congratulations.
Philip Sorlia. Blake Stoltenberg. Grace Thomas. Alexander Tucker. Ananya Vinkatramaya. Seth Voigt.
Congratulations.
Kimberly Wong. Calvin Wu.
Okay, you ready? Dr. Bryson, Superintendent DeGann, Mayor Wheat, and Westlake Academy Board of Trustees, I hereby confirm that our students have successfully completed all the requirements set forth by the Texas Education Agency and by the Westlake Academy Board of Trustees. Class of 2021, you may now move your tassel from the right to the left, signifying the completion of your diploma. You are now Westlake Academy graduates, and from this point forward, will be considered honored Westlake Academy alumni. Class of 2021. Okay.